Hey, I'm Ellie from ZAP-Hosting and today I will show you how you can easily set up your own FiveM txAdmin server easily in 5 minutes. For those who don't know what is a txAdmin, it is a full-feature web panel to manage and monitor your server remotely. It offers features such as access controls, Discord integration, server templates which can be installed with just a few clicks, player management and more. So first, visit our website zap-hosting.com or just click the link in the video description. You now need to log in into your ZAP account with your credentials. If you don't have an account yet, just click on sign up and you can register here for free. After you log in, just navigate to game server, click on FiveM and choose txAdmin mod right here. Here you can configure your own server to your liking. You can choose server location, CPU, RAM, game server slot and IPv4, which is really important if you want to protect yourself from DDoS attacks. Finally, select a payment method and confirm your order. But like always, we have a special voucher for you, so use this code TX50 and get 50% off your txAdmin server today. After you confirm your order, your server will be up in just a minute. Now we need to set up our txAdmin. Go to txAdmin interface by clicking this link right here. We now need to enter our username and password, which can be found under the link right here. After logging in, we land directly in the txAdmin setup. Click on Next. Here we can now select how our server is called. For example, I will call it ZAPTest and click on Next. Now we can choose how exactly we want to set up the server. There are several options here, but for this video I will choose the popular template option. I will leave a document link in the video description where you can read more about other deployment options. After clicking Template, we have two options. CFX Default, which gives us a basic resources, and Plume CX, which gives us a server with a lot of resources that are highly configurable. Choose whatever option you prefer. I will be going with Plume CX. Now we can set up a custom pad for the pack. Generally, we would recommend to leave this pad by default. Click on Save and go to Recipe Deployer. Now, if you want, you can make changes to the recipe. I will leave it as it is. Now scroll down and click on Next. Here, you don't need to change anything at all. Everything is already automatically filled by us, so just click on Run Recipe. After deploy is finished, click on Next. Now you can find your server configuration file. Feel free to change it to your liking, or you can also do this later. I will leave it by default and now click on Save and Run Server. We now successfully finished setting up our txAdmin and have a full control of the interface, so let me show you a little bit around. Okay, here on the dashboard we have a full control of the server. We can start, restart, stop, make an announcement, kick all players, even see the status information, and we can see all the players online. As you can see, there is one player online, which is me, and if I click on it, you can find all the information about the player, you can find all the IDs, you can check the history, you can ban the player, which I'm not gonna do it to myself, you can DM, you can kick, you can even warn the player, which is really awesome because you can do this from the web interface. The admin doesn't need to be logged into the server. Now, if we go to players, we can find all the information about latest bans, warns, whitelist. We could even ban a player who is offline right now. Next, we go to live console. Well, literally everything that is here is just a live console, but if we wanted, we could send a command. Next, we go to resources, and this is really actually cool because we can restart or stop the scripts easily by just one click. So let's say I don't want ambulance job anymore on the server, I just click on stop and that's it. Ambulance job doesn't work anymore on the server, so I can start it again, or if the ambulance job isn't working properly on the server, I could just restart it and maybe that would fix the problem. So just by one click, we can do a lot with this. Next, we have the server logs, where we can access the server logs. Here we have an access to the server configuration file if we wanted to change anything. Here we have diagnostics reports, where we can see a lot of information about host machines, txAdmin information, processes. Well, it might be interesting for you to look. Here we have an admin manager, where we can easily just add an admin and check his all permissions that he will have. So let's say he can only kick players or ban players, and that's it. Here we have a txAdmin log where we can access console logs and action logs. And settings. Well, there's a lot of settings here, so I will go by it really quickly. We could change the server name, we could enable such things as once-ing or auto-start. Also, there's scheduled server restarter. On player manager, we can enable whitelist or disable it, or enable ban list or disable it. And also, we have Discord integration. And of course, there's some new things like backup database, importing bans, and the main option, if you wanted, we can reset our server by just one click. So that is it for today. I hope I helped some of you. If you have any questions, please leave them below in the comment section, and have a lovely rest of the week. Bye!